What's up, y'all? Welcome back. I am Patrick B. Smith, and we're back doing another video by my girl, our girl, Miss Whitney Houston, the voice. Whitney has a lot of music and videos that I have to react to because I have not seen a lot of them, and it's very strange and odd for me to really realize how many of these videos that I have not seen of Whitney, being the fact that I've listened to her all my life. So it just goes to show that the artists and celebrities and singers that you might know probably worked a lot more than you think they have, because there are so many performances that I've run across and I'm like, how did you have so much time to do this? And she's an actress and she was a mom, so I'm like, Whitney was definitely a hard-working woman. But I decided to do another medley because the last medley I did was, it gave me life. You know, you get more than one song, so you get so many different layers of Whitney's voice and her tone, and I am always here for that. But this one particular medley is from 1994. I can imagine what she sounds like, because 94, right after that Bodyguard album and right before Waiting to Exhale, so I know it's going to be great. And it's Whitney, so it doesn't even matter what year it is. It's my girl and I love her. But the three songs she's doing is a song called I Love You, Porgy, which I think that's like a remake of, I'm not too sure, I might be wrong, but I think that Nina Simone sang that before. And then, of course, And I Am Telling You, which, of course, Jennifer Holliday made that really big in Dreamgirls. And then her song, I Have Nothing. So, two songs I have never heard her sing, but I know I've heard her sing I Have Nothing, but not this particular one. So I'm excited about that. And anything to keep Whitney's name alive and in rotation, I am here for it. So definitely ready to do this. Let's go ahead and get into it. I don't know where this is at. Oh, it says it right here. American Music Awards, 1994, when she sweeped up that year. Is that the year? Might be the year, but let's get into it. We'll talk about Whitney at the end. This is her singing another medley. Like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you on the other side.
So, to God is the glory.
Deep inside. So don't make it. It was like very emotional that, my God.
You know, watching that really makes me miss her so much because, first of all, watching Whitney when I do my reaction is such a reassurance of who she is and was, because I always hear other singers sing and I think, oh my God, they are amazing. And then I hear Whitney sing something, I'm like, but she's definitely in a different category. And I don't mean that just because I'm a fan and I'm trying to be biased, but there is something about Whitney's voice and her deliverance. It's just carved particularly for her voice, and she is the master at what she does, because those three songs really did take you on three different journeys. But that first song she did, I love you, Porgy, sorry, I didn't even really know the depth in Whitney's register, in her lower register. I mean, I've heard her drop low, but how low she was going and singing down there. Oh, I mean, much respect to this woman, because the way she is on stage with her charisma as a singer and the way she projects her voice and the clarity in her vocals is magic, because there are lots of singers who you can see them strain for notes and big runs and transitions, but Whitney is just such a pro at that. She can do it willy-nilly like it's nothing. Did you hear how many vocal runs she did on this performance? Oh my God. It was all over the place, but it was so beautiful. I love her higher notes when she sustained up here. Her power notes though, especially on And I Am Telling You, I thought that woman had a gift. And closing the song with I Have Nothing, I kid you not, I felt the emotions in that song. I felt the resonance in her voice. I felt the passion. That last note she did on there, when it got a cappella, Whitney's a queen. And for me, when I do my reactions on Whitney, the reason why take such time to do them, because I want to do her justice. And even with these videos, who knows who's going to see it? I don't really care, but if I attach Whitney's name to anything, it's going to be of great quality, because that's what she deserves and that's what she has always given us. So many more to our girl Whitney. We just love her forever. Rest in peace to the voice. Many more to come. I have probably tons of Whitney's coming, but any more requests, let me know. Otherwise, like, comment, and subscribe, and y'all be safe.